Welcome to the Street Report Connection with Tommy. This video is on your Monday Night Raw results, Superstar spoilers, of course, birthdays, and deaths on this day. Owen Hart fell to his death on this day at the age of 34 on May 23rd, 1999. He was performed in an entrance stunt at WWE's Over the Edge pay-per-view in Kansas City, Kansas at Kemper Arena. Alex Shelley was born on this day. He turned 33. Bray Wyatt also had a birthday, turned 29. Real name of Wyndham Rotunda. Ray Candy, a.k.a. Ray Canty, died of a heart attack on May 23, 1994. He was 42. The late Brian Pillman was born on May 22, 1962. He died of arteriosclerotic heart disease on October 5, 1997. Tracy Brooks, a.k.a. Tracy Brookshaw Girdleum, turned 41 on Sunday. Daniel Bryan turned 35 on Sunday. NXT wrestler Hugo Knox, a.k.a. Stuart Tomlinson, turned 31 on Sunday. Mick McManus turned, he died on May 22nd, 2013, at the age of 93. His real name was William Matthews. WWE Hall of Famer Mr. T, a.k.a. Lawrence Churiad, turned 64 on Saturday. Chris Benoit was born on May 21st, 1967. He took his own life after killing his wife, Nancy, and son, Daniel, on June 24th, 2007. Also was Nancy's birthday, May 21st, 1964. Sasha Banks was reportedly injured during a six-woman match at the May 15th live event in Charlottesville, Virginia. Report from Squared Circle Siren said it was some sort of head injury. An update, Dale Meltzer report confirmed that the injury is why Sasha was off WWE Live events this past week. It appears Sasha was injured by a referee who accidentally caught her with a solid knee to the head. It was described as a freak accident and was not a spot where the referee and Banks were supposed to have serious contact. As of this video, WWE has not confirmed the injury, but word going around is that she suffered a concussion. But keep you updated. From another update, earlier version of the story listed Justin King as a referee who accidentally injured Sasha, but that was an incorrect report, as King is no longer with WWE. Heck, I would have fired him anyways if he was. Hannibal TV released another video of their interview with Demolition Tag Team. In the video, Axe and Smash discuss working with Haku in WWE. Hall of Famer Shawn Michaels did a video intro for Hockey Night in Canada. Apparently was on Sunday night. And you can check out the video at this link. WWE has officially announced TMDK as their newest NXT Tag Team. Tom Phillips and Corey Graves are in a video posted to the WWE NXT Facebook account, which you can see at this link. Which reveals that the team of Shane Thorne and Nick Miller as TM61 will debut it tonight at the NXT tapings. Their new name is a combination of TM, each of their surname initials, and 6-1, their international calling code for Australia, where the duo is from. Again, go to that link, facebook.com/WWE NXT/videos. News 6 in Orlando has posted a story on WWE Performance Center prospects Jeff Logan and Dennis Jackson saving a stray puppy in Orlando. The outlet reports that the two found the dog running in and out of traffic. Again, this link here in Orlando has stopped by to help. A reporter saw the proceedings and interviewed the two, which you can see in the link. WWE Supercard Twitter account posted previews of Finn Balor, however you pronounce the name, Dean Ambrose, and Bret Hitman Hart's new fusion cards. They released for the game on Sunday. I'm going to show you these all three links for the pictures. National Wrestling Hall of Fame Dan Gable Museum has announced that Big E will be attending the George Tragos / Luthez Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame weekend on July 23rd in Waterloo, Iowa. Big E will sign autographs and attend the night's induction banquet. So, expect a spoiler, but he won't be in action that night. Dan Gable said in the press release, I'm excited to have WWE Superstar Big E at one of our biggest events of the year. Working together always yields the best results. We appreciate the support of WWE. Ted DiBiase wrote on Twitter that the George Animal Steel is suffering from health issues. And he wrote, please keep my good friend Jim Myers, a.k.a. George Animal Steel, in your prayers. He's dealing with some serious health issues. Nothing more disclosed. You can follow Ted DiBiase at MDMT, MDM, Ted DiBiase, capital T, and then the D, and then the B. Titus O'Neil was hanging out with Shamus at the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2, Out of the Shadows premiere in New York City on Sunday night. Unknown if that's kayfabe or if anything that... I know Shamus played a heel in the movie, and I'll show you a picture from that event. Titus O'Neil, I don't know what he had to do in the movie. WWE will be sending Mark Henry to WWE Hall of Famer Holly Race's WLW Night of Champions 2 event on August 27th in Troy, Missouri, at the Troy Buchanan High School Gymnasium. Henry is not expected to wrestle a match that night. I don't know what he's supposed to be doing. I guess just signing autographs. But oh well, if he's still in WWE by then. Previously reported, Seth Rollins, WWE's Women's Champion, Charlotte, were named Sports Illustrated Fittest 50 list. Rollins ranked number 24 on the list for men, while Charlotte placed number 24 list for women. Sports Illustrated wrote the following on the two. Rollins, real name, Colby Lopez, better known by his in-ring name. Seth Rollins is one of the WWE's top stars and all-around freak athletes. He suffered a knee injury in November, but has been rehabbing for months to return. Using tools such as Ski-Erg, a machine that mimics Nordic skiing movements, the rowing machine, and of course, some heavy weights. As for Charlotte, Ashley Flair, aka Charlotte, has athletic abilities that extend well beyond WWE. She competed internationally in gymnastics for 7 years, won 3 cheerleading national championships, played volleyball and basketball, and as did swimming, diving, ballet, and track and field. Flair uses everything from kettlebells to pull-up bars and more to sculpt her physique. WWE has came to terms with Adam Rose on his release from his contract. You can read the official statement on WWE.com, but it's probably obviously from his arrest from domestic abuse within the last week or two. And now what you've all been waiting for, dark match results. There wasn't one from Raw. Superstars, spoilers, Zack Ryder defeated Victor of the Ascension. A good pop for Zack Ryder, but the crowd died out during the match itself. Natalya defeated Summer Rae. Dead crowd. Could have cared less. Raw opened up with recapping events from the Extreme Rules pay-per-view. Roman Reigns defeated AJ Styles to retain the WWE World Heavyweight Championship in an Extreme Rules match. Immediately afterwards, Seth Rollins made his return and gave Reigns a pedigree. Rollins then held up the WWE World Heavyweight Champion to end the pay-per-view. Raw video replays and were brought into the arena to see a big pyro techniques display. This is the 1,200th episode of Monday Night Raw. Seth Rollins' music hits, and out he comes to a massive pop from the crowd. He's back to his selfish heel style. Rollins comes out and soaks up the cheers from the crowd, as there were spoiler reports that he was supposed to come back as a face, as Roman Reigns is supposed to turn heel. But not happening. Rollins is sporting completely black hair. He's no longer has a half blonde streak in his hair, kind of like Jeff Hardy. Rollins stands in the ring and soaks in the cheers. A light welcome back chant makes its way through the crowd. A lot of people are booing, but that is mostly drowned out by the cheers. Ronald goes to speak, but he's interrupted by a loud welcome back chant. Ronald is asked if they were going to let him talk. They loudly cheer even more. It's been 200 days, as he says. He's envisioned what it would feel like to step into this ring, his ring, once again. In case you're living under a rock, he's back. For 7 months, he has waited to come back and take the title that he never lost. At Extreme Rules, he fired at the first shot. A still photo of him giving Roman Reigns a pedigree is shown. A thank you Rollins chant fires up from the crowd. Rollins says he feels like the people missed him. And the crowd pops again before starting a yes chant. Rollins says that that's interesting because it wasn't always that way. When he put a steel chair in Roman Reigns' back and destroyed the shield, they booed him every single time he stepped in the ring. They called for his head every night. When he won the World Heavyweight Championship, they called him the weakest champion of all time. They were begging for someone to beat him for the title, even though nobody ever could. They said he was a coward and hid behind the authority every chance he got. They basically discredited every single bit of hard work that went into the title reign. Then something profound happened. His knee buckled up under the weight of carrying this company on his back for so freaking long. Rollins then started getting all these tweets and comments online saying they missed him. Rollins got so much fan mail he didn't even know what to do with it. Rollins says he didn't open a single letter. He put it in a garbage bag, garbage can, and lit it on fire. The crowd starts to lightly boo him. Rollins says he doesn't need any of them. He didn't need them to win the title or defend it every night. Rollins says he doesn't need them to get it back. Rollins says it's okay if they boo him because there is only room for one of them. He didn't need one of them, and this has Rollins bandwagon for one himself. Rollins rehab twice a day to get back to get the title that he never lost. That's 7 months of hard work, which is more work than any of them ever put in their entire lives. He rebuilt himself, redesigned himself, and will take back his World Heavyweight Championship. There are still cheers for him, but the boss, the boos are coming out even louder. Roman Reigns music hits, out he comes to a mixed reaction. Rollins removes his jacket. Reigns gets in the ring. Rollins immediately leaves. The booing is really coming through right now. Rollins talks a little trash, and Reigns invites him into the ring to say it to his face. What that came from. Say it to his face. That was Alex Riley's storyline, who was just one of the last 2 weeks released from WWE. Stupid. Shane McMahon feeds the kids. Out he comes to a big reception. Shane gets in the ring and dances around the ring, doing his stick. Rollins continues to walk around ringside, a loud chain on back. Chance fires up. Shane thanks the crowd for the reception. Shane invites Rollins back into the ring and wants to have an adult conversation. Rollins gets in the ring. You still got it? Champ fires up for no reason. Shane says there's a lot of animosity between the two of them. As Rollins stated, the original time it happened when he turned his back on the Shield. His next defining moment happened at WrestleMania 31 when he cashed in the Money in the Bank contract to walk out the new World Heavyweight Champion. Rollins held that title until his unfortunate injury. Now Rollins is back to get his title that he never lost. Reigns can understand that point. This is a match that has WrestleMania main event written all over it, as Shane said. At WWE's next pay-per-view entitled Money in the Bank, it will be Roman Reigns defending World Heavyweight Championship against Seth Rollins. Rollins shakes hands with Shane as his music plays, and Rollins is very pleased about that and leaves. The Miz will have a Money in the Bank qualifying match against Cesaro. We'll also see Dean Ambrose take on Dolph Ziggler in another Money in the Bank qualifying match. We'll also see Chris Jericho take on Apollo Crews, AJ Styles will fight Kevin Owens, and Sami Zayn faces Sheamus. Those are all the qualifying matches held in one night. Zayn versus Sheamus was first up. Renee Young is backstage with Sheamus. Sheamus says that this is the new era. What kind of era is it? That's him. In a qualifying match against a guy named Sami Zayn. Zayn is from Canada. He's not even from this country. Sheamus says for all the parents with little kids, he advises them to leave the room. What he does to Sami Zayn next won't be suitable for all ages. Money Bank briefcase is hanging above the ring. The bell rings and they take some time before locking up as they're going in the ring. Sheamus quickly powers him into the corner before giving him a clean break. The lockup begins. Sheamus takes him down with a headlock. Take over. Zayn quickly gets out of it. Sheamus takes him down before wrenching the arm. Sheamus applies a side headlock, but Zayn whips him off. Sheamus shoulder blocks him down before hitting the ropes. Zayn leapfrogs and takes him down with a jumping heel kick. Zayn chops the chest and forearms him in the face. Zayn forearms him in the corner before Sheamus clubs him down. Sheamus catches him with a kick to the head before dropping a leg on him. Sheamus elbows away at him before throwing him into the apron. Zayn shoulders him in the midsection before doing a slingshot flip back into the ring. Zayn ducks a clothesline and takes him out of the ring with a head scissor takeover. Zayn follows him out of the ring and attacks him. Sheamus quickly sends him into the barricade. But Zayn jumps to the top of it, takes him out with a moonsault onto the floor. Zayn puts him in the ring. Sheamus quickly knees him in the face as he gets in the ring. Commercial break. We come back in for the break to see Sheamus taunting the crowd. Sheamus trash talking Zayn and points to the Money in the Bank briefcase. Zayn punches back at him, but Sheamus shows him into the ropes and connects with a big power slam for a near fall. Sheamus pops him up on the apron, up on the top rope, goes for a superplex, but Zayn punches him off. Zayn leaps over him, and Sheamus gets up and runs into an Irish Curse backbreaker. Sheamus picks up a near fall. Sheamus hits the ropes, and Zayn viciously clotheslines him down. Zayn approaches him in the corner, but Sheamus kicks him. Sheamus hits the ropes, but Zayn lays him out with a Michinoku driver for a near fall. Sheamus kicks him back and rips him in the face. Sheamus punches away at him and grabs a hand. Zayn scales the ropes, but Sheamus kicks him out from underneath him. Sheamus then poses to the crowd as they boo him. Zayn ducks a bold kick and clotheslines him out of the ring. Zayn sets up for the somersault plancha, but Sheamus forearms him in the face before he does. Sheamus gets back in the ring, and Zayn catches him with a hell of a kick for the win. 2-star rating for the match. Sami is the first one entered into the 2016 Money in the Bank match. Zayn celebrates and leaves the ring. Sheamus gets to his feet and looks furious. Does nothing but then goes back to backstage. Sheamus kicks as he kicks the ropes and pulls at his hair. Still spiked up. Charlotte will deliver a State of the Women's Championship address later tonight. Commercial break. Renee Young backstage with Apollo Crews. She asks him if he has an advantage after witnessing the brutal beating that Chris Jericho experienced at Extreme Rules last night. Crews said Jericho went into thumbtacks and must be feeling like roadkill. Crews said that this is the biggest match of his life. Sheamus attacks him from behind. Sheamus sends him into some crates and then yells about the new era. Sheamus says this is a warning for all new era guys. They can't replace him, and he'll always be there to knock them down. Oh, be more, don't you dare be sour. Clap, clap. For your world famous 2-time tag team champs and feel the power. New Day makes their ring entrance to a huge reaction. This is a cake in there is a cake in the ring that says, Happy Birthday. Xavier Woods says, as of last night at Extreme Rules, the New Day is still your WWE Tag Team Champions as they do the dance and swivel the hips. Crowd alley chairs with them. Kofi Kingston says that this cake is not to help celebrate their victory. Oh no, this cake is out here because Raw has been going strong for 1,200 episodes. That means that Raw is over 23 years old. What they want to say is Happy Birthday, Raw. Big E says we all know that a WWE ring is never safe for a cake. Big E suggests that they take it out of the ring and take care of business. Kofi picks it up and hands it to Big E outside the ring. Wood says to be careful because they wouldn't want it to wind up in anyone's face, particularly anyone in the front row. As a little kid does there, point at the kid, tease that, and then they go to the announce table. Big E has a great look on his face and he prances around ringside with a cake. Big E goes to shove it in JBL's face and he cowers. And then they suggest Byron Saxon, and he begs them off. Social outcasts attack from behind. Attack Woods and kicks him in the ring, and kicked him out of the ring. Then they knock Big E off the apron. They pick up Francesca too, and celebrate in the ring. This six-man action tag is next. Commercial break. New Day versus Social Outcasts. Minus Adam Rose, because he's no longer with them. So the Outcasts are only three members now. We join the match already in progress. Heath Slater goes to the middle rope, but Kofi takes him out with a Hurricanrana. New Day starts up the Unicorn Stampede. It ends with Big E sending Kofi Kingston into Slater with a dropkick. Woods plays a trombone as the rest of the New Day gyrates. Big E tags in and does the snake eyes into the corner as the other two members kick him. Bo Dallas and Curtis Axel hold Slater up. Start off a victory at that. But Slater collapses at ringside from behind. Woods then takes them out with a somersault plancha. Slater is thrown into the ring, and Big E and Kofi connect with the midnight hour for the win. And then they give Heath Slater the cake treatment. But Big E took a big handful of cake in there, and they tell him to put it down. Then they shove Slater face first into it. New Day celebrated as they lay ringside. Coming up next, we see Cesaro taking Miz on in the Money Bank qualifying match. Commercial break. Miz and Maurice made their way out to the ring. Maurice rubs it in the crowd's face as Miz is still WWE Intercontinental Champion. Miz says he's still the Intercontinental Champion and future Money in Bank winner. He's done it once before and will do it again. Since his wife has been by his side, he has been on a roll at Extreme Rules. He was given 25% chance of winning. But like the movie Rudy, he overcame insurmountable odds. It was a drama-filled match. It had social media buzzing. He went up against three of the greatest stars WWE has to offer today. And to the end of it, only one man stood as your Intercontinental Champion, and his name is The Miz. This is truly an underdog story, as he says. But who would play his character? Chris Pratt? Brad Pitt? Dwayne Johnson? Murray says none of those men compare to him. They don't have as good looks and charisma. Saying that The Rock don't have charisma? Miz asks who will win the contract. Murray says he will. Then they go to kiss, but Cesaro's music interrupts him. And you got your match. Bell rings, and Cesaro quickly ducks the clothesline. Cesaro then starts up the uppercut train before taking him down with a one last uppercut for a two count. Cesaro hits the ropes for a number of times to showcase his athleticism before connecting with a dropkick for a near fall. Maurice then pulls Miz out of the ring. Cesaro gets on the apron and takes Miz out with a somersault senton off the apron. Maurice yells at him, but Cesaro holds up his hands and says, "Talk to the hand." Miz attacks Cesaro as he gets in the ring and goes for a suplex. But Cesaro blocks it and goes for a delayed vertical suplex. But Miz knees him in the head. Cesaro keeps him up, held up, and powers him into a suplex for a two count. Cesaro then applies a headlock, but Miz fights up. Miz whips him off and goes for a leapfrog, but Cesaro counters into a power slam attempt. But Miz slides out and sends him into the ropes. But Cesaro takes him out with a springboard spinning uppercut that sends Miz out of the ring. Commercial break. When we come back from the break, we see Cesaro holding his shoulder, the injured one, that was taped up. Miz rakes his face. Cesaro fights out. Miz quickly takes him out with a reality check before signaling for the skull-crushing finale. Cesaro counters into an inside cradle for a two-count. Miz finally attacks the injured shoulder before hitting a kneeling DDT for a two-count. Miz then punches at him. Cesaro rolls to the apron to recover. Miz then catches him with a guillotine catapult. Miz viciously pulls at the arm. Cesaro goes outside to recover. Miz charges into an uppercut. Cesaro blocks a punch and uppercuts him a few more times. Miz comes back with a shot to the injured shoulder. Miz then connects with a patented corner clothesline. Miz goes up to the top rope, but Cesaro drop kicks him off to the floor. Cesaro then takes him out with a running uppercut. Cesaro puts him in the ring, goes up top. Cesaro then connects with a crossbody block for a two count. Cesaro goes for the Cesaro swing, but Miz kicks him off. Cesaro then gives him a double stomp to the midsection for a near fall. Referee backs Cesaro up. Miz kicks him in the shoulder. Cesaro then goes for a Cesaro swing, but his shoulder doesn't allow it to happen. Miz goes for a skull crushing finale, but Cesaro elbows out. Cesaro gives him a back body drop to the apron, but Miz lands on his feet and snaps an arm off the top rope. Miz goes to the top rope, but Cesaro uppercuts him out of midair, and then connects with a neutralizer for the win. Another two-star match. Cesaro joins in the Money in the Bank match as number two. A replay shown from earlier tonight when Shane McMahon both booked Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns to face off at Money in the Bank pay-per-view. Renee Young is backstage with Seth Rollins. Rollins says it would be a fitting environment for him to win the title. A few years back, he won his contract there and went on to have the greatest cash-in in WWE history. Shane McMahon walked up. Rollins goes for a hug, but she holds him back. Rollins says, it's been so long, her brother gave the championship match for the title. He never lost. Stephanie says things have changed around here, including their business relationship. She extends her hand and welcomes him back. They shake hands and she walks off. Chris Jericho makes his way to the ring limping and his back covered in bandage. Jericho will face Apollo Crews in the next qualifying match. John Cena is advertised to return for Monday Night Raw on next week. If they go to commercial break. Replays are shown of Sheamus attacking Apollo Crews earlier tonight. Crews is showing no signs of the attack as he jumps and dances his way to the ring. The bell rings as Jericho throws a t-shirt at him and punching him and kneeing away at him. Jericho sends him into the ropes and connects with a back elbow. Jericho taunts the crowd before kicking Crews. Jericho slaps him in the head a few times before kneeing him in the face. Jericho chops the chest and hits the ropes, but Crews drop kicks him down. Crews connects with an arm drag before catching him with a suplex. Crews executes a slingshot senton for a two count. Sheamus is watching the match from backstage. Crews punches him in the corner before running into a back elbow. Crews kicks him in the bandages, and Jericho screams in pain. Crews then body slams him down. The referee backs him up, and Jericho punches him before clotheslining him back in the back of the head. Jericho taunts the crowd as he hits a snap suplex before drop kicking him in the head for a two count. Jericho talks some more trash before Crews fights back. Jericho drops him down for a two count. Jericho then punches him in the head a few times before kicking him in the back. Jericho applies a chin lock, but Crews fights up. Jericho chops him in the back and sends him into the ropes for a two count. Jericho punches him in the head a few more times, kicking him in the back again. Then he applies a chin lock. Crews fights up, chops him back, sends him to the ropes again. Crews kicks him in the head and clotheslines him twice. Crews hits the ropes and kicks him in the head. Crews then avalanches him in the corner and connects with a jumping back elbow. Crews kicks up and Jericho drops him to the apron. Jericho goes for a springboard dropkick, but Crews moves. Jericho crashes and burns at ringside. Crews then takes him out with a standing moonsault off the apron. Crews put him in the ring and goes to the top rope. Jericho avoids the leap before running into a power slam. Crews picks up a two count. Crews connects with an enziguri, but Jericho doesn't go down. Jericho counters a set out powerbomb into a roll up. Jericho releases the deposit walls of Jericho. Crews claws his way to the bottom rope. Crews drop kicks him and rolls him up for a two count. Crews forearms away at him before sending him into the ropes, but Jericho avoids the drop kick. Crews tries to keep up to avoid a lion talk, but he timed it wrong. Crews kicked out at two. That didn't look pleasant. Jericho chopped the chest and goes for a walk to Jericho, but Crews rolls him up for a two count. Jericho then connected with a code breaker for the win. One star match. Jericho joins in for the match at Money in the Bank pay-per-view. Sheamus looks happy with the result as they show him backstage. Renee Young asks for his reaction. Sheamus just laughs and walks off. Later tonight, we see AJ taking on Kevin Owens in a Money in the Bank qualifying match. Commercial break. Another Darren Young, Bob Backlund, split-screen vignette. They're attempting to make Darren Young great again. JoJo backstage with Baron Corbin. Footage shown of Corbin giving Dolph Ziggler a low blow last night. Corbin getting the victory from there. She asked for comments on those critical of his victory. Corbin could care less what people think. He did that to Dolph Ziggler because he can. Ziggler walked up and asked about things that he can't do, like putting three words together. Looking like a tool and competing in a technical wrestling match, Corbin grew up giving out beatings to punks like Ziggler. Then he was told if he's good at something, you don't do it free. That's why he's here. When he's done breaking Ziggler's body, we'll discuss his technical wrestling. Ziggler says we'll see if Corbin can hang with him in a technical wrestling match next week. Ziggler tells Corbin to watch his match against Dean Ambrose later tonight. He'll do what Corbin can't, steal the show. Big Cass makes his way to the stage with a big pop. Big Cass goes to talk, but then he waves his hand. Enzo Amore makes his return to a tremendous reception. Crowd's going nuts here now. Enzo says he's a certified G and a bona fide stud. And you can't teach that. As for Big Cass, he's 7 foot tall and you can't teach that. They get in the ring and the crowd chants, "How you doing?" Enzo dances around a bit. Enzo says that as most of the people are aware, he forgot to pay his electric bill. They cut his lights out. "How you doing?" The doctor diagnosed him with a concussion. The crowd boos that. Enzo says that's what he likes to call hard sneeze. And then does the dab. Enzo says he's got the gift of gab and the gift of jab. If he had a dime for every time he got knocked down and didn't back up, he would have 0 dimes. As for those couple of haters, Bub and Devon Dud, they have been out of line and apparently not on the guest list. So do them a favor and don't do them any favors. At the end of the day, the Dudleys are full of baloney. That boar's head on Bubba's shoulder is good for one thing because Big Cass isn't a delicatessen. It's a target. Big Cass says him putting his size 16 boot on Bubba's head is like throwing a basketball into a swimming pool because he's not going to miss. Enzo gets the crowd going with his wild antics. Big Cass says he'll prove again why there's only one word to describe the Dudley boys. And he'll spell it out for them. S-A-W-F-T. Solve. Dudley boys make their entrance, but Bubba Ray will face Big Cass next. And we get to commercial break treatment. Big Cass with Enzo versus Bubba with Devon. They lock up. Big Cass powers him into the corner. Bubba turns him around and chops to the chest. Big Cass just stares him at him before shoving him down. Bubba looks stunned. They lock up before Bubba puts Cass in the corner. Bubba gives a clean break before going for a cheap shot. Big Cass hits him hard into the turnbuckles. As Bubba's face plants, Devon attacks Enzo at ringside. Bubba attacks Big Cass from behind and gives him a back suplex. Bubba jabs away at Big Cass before hitting a clothesline. Big Cass connects with a pair of shoulder blocks before hitting an avalanche. Bubba goes outside. Big Cass follows. Big Cass then sends Enzo into Devon. In the ring, Bubba goes for the top rope. Goes up to the top rope. Big Cass throws him off before connecting with a big boot and the Empire Elbow for the win. 3/4 star. Charlotte walking backstage with Ric Flair and Dana Brooke. She'll talk about the Women's Championship next. Commercial break. Charlotte comes out arm in arm with Ric Flair and Dana Brooke. Charlotte gets on the microphone and lets out a woo. Ric Flair takes the microphone and the crowd buzzes. Flair says before she starts tonight, he wants to convey her father as a father, how proud he is of her for everything she's accomplished since she won the WWE Championship at WrestleMania. Well, I did not see this part myself. I fell asleep. Again, boring. I didn't even see the previous match. Well, she goes on to say, as a child, every time he turned around, she had her hand in the candy jar. Even when they hit it, she found it. Everything she's touched in her life, she's made happen. She's that fabulous. Last night with her back against the wall, she once again prevailed. She even got someone like her uncle, Arn, in Dana Brooke. Without Charlotte Flair, there is no Dana Brooke. Flair says he's proud of her. Charlotte wants to thank one person, and that's obviously herself. She's also proud of Dana Brooke. She made the right decision because she wants to be the best. Dana thanks Charlotte for the opportunity to stand in the ring with the dirtiest player in the game. Charlotte asks Flair knows what she remembers growing up. She remembers Thanksgiving, Christmases, and birthdays. The crowd gives her what treatment? She dares them to say what? One more time, she remembers her mother saying her father would always be there, but he wasn't. She had to watch him on TV. She understands why he wasn't there. Her mother had to rub her hair because she was crying. But she gets it now because she's the WWE Women's Champion. She's never been more powerful or confident. Now she understands. Her father knew what it was like to be the man. She's the woman. She's why she has courage to say this to her father. Get out of my ring, she asks if he's hard of hearing. She's figured he's standing there looking dumbfounded. Everyone from his generation is the same. They never want to leave the spotlight. She was compassionate enough to let him bask in her success. Does anyone know what it's like to walk in a room and be called Ric Flair's daughter? He's Charlotte's dad. She asks if he's going to cry. Her spotlight shines brighter than his ever did. Flair begins to cry. Charlotte appears like she's on the verge of tears saying all these things. Charlotte says Ric Flair abandoned her for the last 30 years of her life. Ric Flair is immortal to the fans, but to her, he's dead. Now she can watch her on TV like she had to do for him. She tells him to get out of the ring. Flair sadly leaves the ring and she sings Kiss Him Goodbye at him. Commercial break. All three commentators are discussing by Charlotte's action against her father. Well, I'll wake up at the end of this. Later on I'll wake up. I'm doing this. I woke up in the Dean Ambrose Dolph Ziggler match. And to me, I believe this was the match of the night right here. They lock up. Ambrose takes him down with a waist lock. Ziggler quickly gets up. Ambrose catches him with a snapmare for one count. Ziggler takes him down with a fireman's carry for one count. They go to a test of strength. Ambrose kicks him and takes him down with an armbar. Ziggler quickly rolls him up for a one count. They lock up again. Ambrose applies a hammerlock. Ambrose takes him down with a headlock takeover. Ziggler soon fights up and whips him off. Ambrose runs him over with a shoulder block. Ambrose hits the ropes. Ziggler drop kicks him for a two count. Ziggler applies a side headlock and takes him down to slow the match down. Ambrose whips him off and connects with a back elbow. Ambrose connects with a body slam for one count. Ambrose chops the chest before putting him in a corner. Ambrose sends him into the ropes. Ziggler catches him with a sunset flip. They trade pins before Ambrose throws him out of the ring. Ambrose feigns a dive, but Ziggler moved. We're at a stalemate as we go to commercial break. Back from the break, we see Ziggler fight out of a superplex attempt. Ambrose punches him and then catches him with a double arm superplex for a near fall. Ambrose then connects with a running forearm and goes for a bulldog, but Ziggler pushes him in the corner and hits an avalanche. Ambrose gets out of a neck breaker. Ambrose also counters a DDT at a clothesline and clotheslines him out of the ring. Ambrose hits the ropes and nearly kills himself on a sloppy suicide dive. Ambrose puts Ziggler in the ring and goes to the top rope, but Ambrose shoves him off. Ambrose takes him down with an elbow. But Ziggler rolls through and gets a two count. Ziggler connects with a famous air for a near fall. Ziggler tunes up the band, HBK style. But Ambrose blocks a super kick. They go into the ropes and take each other out with a double cross body block. They trade punches until Ziggler super kicks him. Ambrose then catches him with a rebound clothesline, as he always does for a near fall. Ambrose goes back up to the top and Ziggler dropkicks him in midair. Ziggler punches away at him in the corner. Ambrose goes for a powerbomb, but Ziggler rolls him up for a two count. Ambrose counters a zigzag and connects with the Dirty Deeds for the win. Well, this one gets a 1.5 star, but I still give it match of the night. Ric Flair is sadly walking backstage past a few superstars before bumping into Arn Anderson. They hug, and Anderson says he's sorry. Renee Young comes up to him and says this is a horrific night Flair didn't get a chance to respond, so she gives him a chance. Flair shakes his head, says something inaudible, and walks off. Coming up next, we will see AJ Styles take on Kevin Owens in a Money in the Bank qualifying match. Commercial break. Shining Stars talk about how great their debut was last week on Raw. Since everyone loves them so much, they invite the WWE Universe to Puerto Rico. AJ Styles makes his way to the ring. Still photo shown from his war against Roman Reigns last night. Styles in this business. You never know how good someone is until you get in the ring with them. After the last six weeks at Extreme Rules, Roman Reigns is every bit the man he says he is. The crowd loudly boos at that. Reigns is one of the better men he's ever been in the ring with. However, it wasn't for the Usos. He had him beat. If it wasn't for them, we'd be looking at the new World Heavyweight Champion. That didn't happen. But he has an opportunity tonight. Styles has the opportunity to beat Kevin Owens on his own. Well, cue in our Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows making their way into the ring, looking none too pleased. Carl Anderson tells them to take it back a second. Styles makes it sound like he didn't want them out there fighting with him last night. Styles says that is the case. This isn't Japan. That is the case. This isn't Japan. Things have changed. Anderson says if this was Japan, he'd have bought them around for helping him. Anderson says Styles has changed. Styles says things may have been lost in translation. He didn't get them into WWE to watch his back. Luke Gallows says if they didn't drop every guy he ever had a problem with, there's a lot of bar fights and he wouldn't have walked out of. If they didn't drop everyone here, Styles never would have made it to Extreme Rules. Styles says he sees what's happening here. He doesn't want their professional lives to break up their friendship. Professionally, they need to separate. Styles says for right now, they're done. Styles says he doesn't care what the crowd thinks. Nothing and no one can separate them from being brothers. Gallows says, how dare you talk about us like that and try to stand here and call us brothers? Anderson says they're not brothers anymore. They're not friends anymore. Styles says, if that's the way it is, then they don't need to be in the ring together. As of right now, this is his ring. Anderson and Gallows turn and leave the ring. Advertisement again. John Cena will return next week's Monday night. On SmackDown this week, Cesaro will face The Miz in the second round of... this is for the Intercontinental Championship match next week. Also, Rusev will defend his U.S. Championship against Kalisto in a rematch. Next up, we get bell ringing for the AJ Styles and Kevin Owens match. Both men look up at the Money in the Bank briefcase. They talk trash to one another and shove each other. Trade punches with Styles coming out on top. Owens kicks him back and replies to side headlock. Owens calls himself the headlock master. Styles whips him and leapfrogs him. Owens holds on to the ropes to avoid a dropkick. Owens derisively claps for him before running into a dropkick. Styles picks up a one count. Styles connects with a snapmare and drops a knee on it for a two count. Styles chops to the chest, but Owens fights back. Styles has a whip reverse on him. As he kicks Owens in the face, Styles hits the ropes. Owens connects with a textbook dropkick for a no count. Owens kicks him back in the head and goes for the body slam, but Styles slides out. Styles applies a waist lock, but Owens takes him down and taunts to the crowd. Styles quickly takes him down before throwing him out of the ring. Styles goes for a poncha, but lands on the apron when Owens moves. Owens then pulls him off. Owens teases the poncha, but he simply rolls under the bottom rope and closes on the floor. Owens puts Styles back in the ring and yells at Michael Cole. Styles punches him from ringside and connects with a forearm plancha. Owens punches him back before Styles sends him into the steel steps. Styles puts him in the ring and we've got a commercial. Back from the break to see Styles trapped in a chin lock. During commercial break, Owens drops Styles face first on the apron. Back to live action. Styles punched out and charged him, but Owens gives him a back body drop out of the ring. Owens goes to powerbomb him onto the steel Seth, but Styles drives him into the apron. Styles gets him in the ring, and then they trade punches. Owens does a strike combination and lifts him up. But Styles gets out and takes him down. Styles hits a low forearm smash for a near fall. Styles put him in the corner, but Owens punches him back to get out. Styles then hits a set-out face buster for a near fall. Styles goes for Styles' class, but Owens gives him a back body chop. Styles elbows him back and goes to the second rope, but Owens pulls him off and gives him a German suplex. Owens then catches him with a cannonball for a near fall. Owens then tells Michael Coleslaw to shut up. Owens heads into the ropes, but Styles hangs on and boots him back. Owens ducks a kick, but Styles comes right back with a German suplex. Styles catches him with an insecure before hitting a fireman's carry neck breaker for a near fall. Owens counters out of a Styles clash. Again, it hits a fisherman suplex neck breaker for a near fall. Owens sets him up and goes up to the top rope. Styles cuts him off and goes for a superplex, but Owens headbutts him. Owens leaps up and goes for a moonsault. But Styles moves. Styles connects with a springboard 450 splash for a near fall. Owens rolls out of the ring to recover. Styles jumps up onto the top rope for a plunge, but Owens moves, so he goes to the apron. Owens then gives a running knee to the face. Styles charges him, but Owens counters with a power bomb onto the steel steps at ringside. Owens gets in the ring and looks for the count out. Styles just barely beats the count. Owens sends him into the ring ropes for a pop-up powerbomb. But Styles gets out, connects with a penalty kick for a near fall. Styles quickly goes to the apron and waits for Owens to get up. Owens quickly kicks the top rope out from under and catches him with a pop-up powerbomb for a clean win. Well, this match ties as your match of the night. Two spots to fill for your Money in the Bank briefcase. And as Raw was going off the air, Mick Foley was saying greeting Shane McMahon backstage. Live interview on the network. And that concluded Raw. And there was no results for the Dark Match main event because there wasn't one. If there was one, I'll post it on the SmackDown video. There wasn't one advertised on the Arena website, so that's going to be it for my video. Thanks again. Peace out. See you one more minute. If you don't know, just call me brothers and sisters.